Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Tuesday, the 23rd of October, 2018. What a great weekend in Kelowna. It's Tuesday today, didn't do a video yesterday, of course. I was busy editing all that footage together. It's really quite long. I'm watching the cat over in there's a new neighborhood tabby, and he's over there there's three cats over there that are, I guess they're probably just going crazy. He's just, anyway, cats. Yeah, the editing was really long. It took me quite a while to, like, crack all that together. And a couple, one time, you know, and you've got to, there's one thing I've learned a lesson over the years of computer, save your work as you're progressing. I've done it so many times. You know, 2 hours of editing, you're going all of a sudden, and then it just freezes. And then it just craps the bed, and you get started all over again. So, luckily, I had that moment, it happened to me. And I was good though, I was saving all along, and then I was like, oh, I haven't saved in a while, or I haven't saved, or I thought I hadn't saved, and I went to do something, and it crashed, and I was like, oh crap, when did I save last, you know? And then, luckily enough, it was one minor change, and then it was good. So, hope you enjoyed the video. I enjoyed the course a lot. Like, I'm really gonna hopefully step up my firefighter training. I don't know what I'm going to do. I got to see what the military VA section is going to want to. Anyway, we'll see how it goes. But it was really great. Met a good bunch of people. Learned a lot. I'm still literally, like, as I'm going now and I'm talking to you guys and girls, I'm still, it's in my head. I'm going through procedures and, yeah, I'm running through scenarios right now as what am I going to do if this happens? And then I can't seem to stop now. It's unbelievable. But yeah, like I said, a really fun time, and I'm really enjoying the volunteer fire department here. So hopefully that can continue, because with everything, there's always politics, right? So, and even with us in a small town here with barely 2,000 people, politics. Politics, you know? You just want to barf when you talk about it, eh? When politics get involved, it just gets your hackles up. You're like, well, no, and you say this, we need this, it's an entity that makes a decision for you when you know you need something. You're like, it's politics get involved, and you just want to punch somebody, right? Anyway, that's wrong. Can't punch somebody over it. Punch a Nazi! Anyway, what can I tell you? But anyway, enough about that. I was just pouring through a video. I was just watching Joe from the Carolinas interviewing Rice? I can't remember his first name, but it's all along with the space stuff. The aliens and secret space program. And I'm of a mind that because, you know, I can remember back when, you know, like, because this goes way back, like, I'm talking the first time I can remember all the, you know, loosely conspiracy stuff that I started following. I could go back to probably the late 90s. We'll go that far back. And that's when I started, you know, kind of looking into it. And I think that this latest SSP stuff is just a rollout. I think we've got something coming down the pipe, and this is just another rollout. Deaden the brain pan for the public, you know, because we all know that the military is so way ahead advanced of all of the normal technology. You know, they probably have replicator technology that we don't know about, and we're still stuck with microwaves in our home. You know what I mean? It's just like that envy, you know. We can go back and look about envy, just small basic stuff. Technology, you know, they came out with the Hummer, now all civilians are driving Hummers. You know, it's just so when they're all running around doing the secret space program stuff, I'm of a mind that it's half and half, you know, half gobbledygook, half reality, you know, mishing in a bit of garbage with a bit of reality. And yes, I completely believe that we probably have aircraft that can, you know, are not outside our system, but spacecraft that could possibly navigate our system. Now, whether it be piloted, I'm not going to comment. I would say no, just for the mere fact that it's much easier and the vehicle can do a lot more maneuvers when there's not a bag of water in it that you worry about killing. So I'm of that mind. So when, if anything does come about with, you know, all of a sudden there's an alien invasion or anything like that, I will know in my heart that it's not blue avian chicken people or, you know, lizard beings from, you know, like Star, if you remember Voyager with the distant origin theory episode, you know, the lizards from Earth that left and then developed in another region of space and then they came back. Or not in Voyager, but in my Voyager twist, they come back and then they take over because they were here before and they don't like mammals. That's what the common thread that I noticed right away with the Voyager one. Ew! Come from a planet with mammalian species on it? Ew! I just have to laugh about that kind of stuff. So very interesting. I just watched a bit of the video with Joe from the Carolinas. It was live, so I don't want to... I'm cooking, and I'll go back and watch it later. Just to parse through, it seems that Joe seems to be fairly sincere in his search for truth, like a lot of other channels that I'm subscribed to as well. And he's not bitter, he's just looking for answers. I find some of the other channels are a little bit bitter. You know, things didn't go the way I wanted to go in my life, so I'm just going to make the poo-poo on everybody else. But, I digress. One thing I did want to touch on today, and I've been noticing it, that because it's I was at the coffee shop this morning listening to the water cooler conversation, and the Khashoggi thing is getting a lot of traction. And I'm of a mind that, you know, this could be a thing that happens elsewhere to get the ball rolling so that they can get the move. Like it doesn't put Saudi in a good light. There's people like, because allegedly, supposedly, whateverly, that this fellow was a staunch supporter of the kingdom. He was not a supporter of Mohammed bin Salman. So, there again, I'm just going from what I read, okay? And what I hear and what I'm seeing. So, something is up, and I've noticed, and the overall thing and the thread that I'm getting in my mind right now is something is wrong. Can't put my finger on it, but something is amiss. And I know I've said this before, and I'm not trying to poo-poo or doom, you know? I'm just saying that something, if you look at the planet, You know, I find that people are increasingly more and more extricating themselves from any situation that causes distress to the point now where they're cocooning themselves or echo chambering themselves. It's like, yeah, I know the world's crazy, I'm just going to turn it off. I'm going to shut it all off and then I can ignore it, it's not going to bother. As their bubble gets smaller and the world encroaches, they're going to find themselves in a really world of poop when it comes time that their bubble gets popped and they're left sitting there naked. So something is amiss, you know, the Khashoggi thing with all the kind of craziness and all the rollouts and, you know, the disclosure. And that's another thing I noticed too with disclosure. People are talking about disclosure. And everybody associated immediately with aliens and stuff like that. I said, no, maybe it's just, and I read an article, the disclosure of the hypocrisy. We're not going to have a disclosure of alien tech. It's a disclosure of, oh, we were right. They have been lying to us. It's going to be that kind of disclosure. You know, it's going to be that, like, you know, and if we can, you know, go to scripture or whatever, or look at, you know, what I like to think of as my good orderly direction, God, what have you, is that the veil is slowly being lifted, and I'm of the opinion that it's being lifted quicker than for some. So the disclosure is the veil being lifted, and finally, just like literally, you can read something and it says aliens are real, but you see the truth in the headline. Aliens are fake. And I'm just using that as an example. Saying that, I'm just using it as an example. So you read it, and you see it, and you hear it coming out of the idiot box, or out of the idiot paper, or out of the idiot internet, but you see through the level of the veil, and then you see what's really happening. You know, they're using your discernment, your gray matter, all of your tools, you know, your your ability to analyze and everything like that, and finally trust your gut and come down to say, okay, yes, this is what they're saying, but the mathematics makes this the reality. Okay? Yeah, they're saying 2 plus 2 equals 17. But in all reality, I'll give them 5, but the better answer would be 4. You know? It just seems that simple to me. It just seems that clear. That clear. You know? Anyway. I don't know what to tell you. Anyway, I'm rambling. I'll end it there. Quick video. Got to get my breakfast in me. A lot of things in my head. I'll think of some new topics. I know I want to do the knife video. I saw my friend member, and I just completely forgot, because I want to do that. And I also want to do a marijuana video on the ins and outs of exactly what. Because, you know, like Sunday, we were out Sunday, and of course, driving back, and, you know, like, it's like they're right out in the street, you know, wah, wah, wah. And I'm like, you can't do that. That's not what the rules say. You know, if there's a smoking area, allegedly or supposedly, you can smoke your pot in that area, but you can't just walk down the sidewalk blasting a marijuana cigarette. I believe it's the same as, but, you know, everybody's like, oh, great, free for all. And you know, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, you know. But anyway, we'll see how it unfolds. It just seems to be a bit loosey-goosey right now, and we'll just let the rules go. And you know what happens when that goes, you know? Well, we won't do anything. We'll just sit back and watch what happens, yeah. We'll just sit back and let the right and the left be across the street from each other and see what happens, and maybe we'll intervene a little later on. Yeah, see how that goes. Anyway. Good to be home. Cat was pissed. You know? But yeah, I got good neighbors, you know? But she's still like, where were you? Anyway, peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side.